Hi everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. So I've been using these plastic reusable canning lids for about a year now, and I really like them, especially because you don't have to throw away the metal lid every time you open a jar, and that really adds up if you're using them for your lunch every day. The only problem I have with them is that they're made of plastic. And so I thought I'd see what would happen if I tried making one out of metal. So here's a chunk of tin. Food grade, of course. So I've made a mold of the lid in plaster, as you can see. Even put a reverse Cody'sLab insignia in there. And so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to melt some tin, and we're going to get something and smash it flat, and it should be left with a chunk of tin that's in the shape that I can use for the lid. All right, looks pretty smooth. It's got a big gas bubble in there. That might not be a deal breaker though. That might still function, as the outside here is all intact. Let's save this one, but let's still try again. Though. Well, it broke the mold, but I think it's salvageable. Just clean it up a little bit. So here's the two lids I managed to make, all cleaned up. This one you can see that I've crimped it a little bit. How I did that was I put it on a jar and I just tightened it down really tight. Tin's such a soft metal, you can pretty easily deform it like that. So now I don't see any reason why this gasket wouldn't fit into there. You'd just be able to seal a jar with it. Yeah, what's wrong with that? Kind of expensive because, you know, tin's something like $20 a pound, but it should work. It's not toxic. This other one, let's do something a little different, maybe a little more DIY. And let's put some silicone on here and see if that'll work. We'll see why it wouldn't. And here are the finished lids. Let's go use them for canning. How about some peaches? So here's our jar of peaches. I'm going to cheat a little bit and use the vacuum chamber to drive the air out rather than hot water. This is much simpler and faster to reset, so it should be easier on us. Okay, make sure that's centered. Let's tighten the band on there just like I would if I was doing the hot water bath. There we go. Maybe a little bit looser. There. So the idea is the air can force its way out, but once the air is gone, it won't continue boiling and throw all the liquid up out of there and maybe get some of the peach fiber stuck in the seal, because that would keep it from sealing properly. All right, so that one's probably good. Now let's do the silicone sealed one. The problem with this one is I'm not going to be able to tighten it down as much. That seal will probably get ruined. It's just, yeah, just very lightly seal it on there. All right, let's close this up. There we go. And I'll turn on the vacuum. Let's see, is there an air bubble in there we can focus on? Not really, I must have did a pretty good job. I'm sure air bubbles will show up once we start sucking out the air though. So vacuum pump on. There we go. Oh, there's one. Yeah, it's definitely a bubbling now. The pressure drops. And also the liquid's going up. That's not good. It's going to start boiling over. Well, we might have avoided it. Oh, we're leaking a little bit on the back one. I can't really see it on the camera. Might be able to see a little bit of liquid down there. It's just turning to foam. In the vacuum. Yeah, a little bit is okay. As long as we don't get any peach fiber up on the seal. Now let's turn the vacuum pump off. And let's just let the air work its way out for a few minutes. And then we'll turn on the air and slam it down with the atmospheric pressure. Hopefully that makes a good seal. If not, we'll just have to try again. All right, I'm gonna turn on the air. Oh, sprayed peach juice everywhere. Well, there it is. Let's see how they look. Take the ring off. See if it sealed. Ha! It did. You see, I can lift it up by the metal lid there. Perfect. So that one worked. That was the silicone gasket. This one did not. This one was the one that was boiling over a lot more. Yeah, you can see some peach fiber on the seal there. So, I'll just have to clean it off and try again. You can see I put a little bit more liquid in there to make up for what was boiled off. I'm going to tighten that up quite a bit more than I did the first time. I think it's just not tight enough. You know, the lid I made is not perfectly flat, so I guess it has to be tighter to compensate. So, let's vacuum it down again. Hopefully this time there's less air bubbles in there too, so that'll also help. Nope, it didn't seal again. I can already tell it didn't seal. Well, this is of course why we're doing it in the vacuum chamber. So if this was the hot water bath, this would have taken hours every time. So, okay, as tight as I can get it. Let's see if that works. All right, so this is actually attempt 4. Let's see if it worked this time. Ah, it did. Okay. Yeah, see? It holds.
finally sealed. Now, of course, getting the air out of the jars is only part of the process. The most important part, of course, is to kill all the bacteria and fungus that are living on the peaches. And to do that, we use heat of boiling water. So, they're currently warming up. Once it gets up to temperature, you know, the water's boiling, then I'll let it sit there for 20 minutes and then I'll let it cool off. Normally, the hot water would cause the air to expand and force its way up out of the jars. And then once it cools back off, it creates a partial vacuum, holds the lid shut. But we've already got the vacuum in there, so that's not a problem. In fact, I've tightened the lids down nice and tight, much tighter than I would normally. Hopefully, there's not too much pressure that builds up in there. Just in case these lids do blow off, I'm going to be standing well back once it gets up to the temperature. Yeah, hopefully this works. I'll see you guys in a bit. Alrighty. They're done. Just gotta let them cool. Hopefully they seal. I guess it's time to see if it worked. They've cooled off. It looks like the lid's tight. So the silicone seal worked. Awesome. Let's try this other one with the rubber gasket. Oh, I really cranked that on there, didn't I? Let's see. Yeah, we're good. They're sealed. Alright, now I guess it's just time to see if they keep. So I'm down in the pantry. And this is where I'll be storing these peaches, right next to the green beans that we canned back in February. February 19th, in fact. Tell you what, I'll open these all up on November 19th. That way I can have the video out by Thanksgiving. I probably won't eat the green beans because, well, beans grow botulism and, you know, I'm not super confident that this was sealed properly, but I'll definitely be eating the peaches. And actually, you know, there's something I've been wanting to try. Let's see, I've got some of these commercially canned peaches here. Let's open this up and see what the lining of this is. You know, hit it with the x-ray. Because I've heard that it is actually tin, but I don't know for sure. So let's test the outside bottom of this can. See what that's made out of. So it's telling me that it's carbon steel. It's a bunch of random elements. Let's have a look at the peaks. Okay, there's the iron peak. If we keep zooming in, we should see a peak at about 5.4 and 5.9. Yeah, so that looks like chrome. Although, yeah, there's probably manganese in this peak as well. That's why it's so high. Anyway, let's cut open the can. You see, on the inside here, it's got a different metal. See that? Like the top and bottom look like this, is the chrome steel. Let's see what this is. So I'm going to set this on top of a block of wax, just so nobody can complain about the table, you know, if it's interfering. I don't think the x-rays could actually go through this tin, though. Not with the energy I'm using. Yeah, there's tin. See that? It's going to be a thin coating, so it'll give me a low percentage. So looking at the graph for the energies, we can see a nice big peak for the iron, because the iron is still most prevalent. So if we zoom in over here, around 25, 28, so 25.27, we should see a peak for tin. Yeah, right about there. That's the main peak for tin.
And there should be a secondary peak at about 28.45-ish. Yep, right there. So they are lined with tin. As far as I know, peaches are the only food that is still canned in actual tin-plated steel. Supposedly the tin imparts a good flavor to the peaches. Anyway, hope you enjoyed. I'll see you next time.